first time I heard the term space, I was very young. It was either in the science fiction movies that talk about aliens that are attempting to get control on our planet Earth, or the wars between the human race and extraterrestrial one. But we never try to admire the beauty of the harmony existing in the universe when we raise up our eyes toward the sky. Hey, I am Lamiss and I'm glad you introduced my video. First of all, the term binary star was brought up in the 18th century by William Herschel. He is a German musician who's become interested to the astronomy. Then he assumed that the red planet, Mars, had an atmosphere. As well, he observed three red spots at the dark side of the moon that led the scientists to presume again that the moon had a volcano. And in the 1802, he used the term binary star to define his own concept by a true double star is the union of two stars formed together in the system by the laws of universal attraction. So the binary star is a system consisting by two different stars. The brighter one is officially classified as the primary one, called A, while the dumber one is the secondary, called B. Actually, most of stars are in the binary system, and these two stars are turning around their common center of mass, called the barycenter. And the barycenter, as we learned this year in high school's lesson in mathematics and chemistry, is a center of weight or center of balance. I will explain it more in my experiments. I will take two balls having the same mass, and I will link with them with a rope, and then throw them in the air. Now I take two other balls having different masses, which one of them is massive than the other, and I will link again between these two spheres and toss them in the air. We observe the barycenter wasn't in the middle, but it was much closer to the massive one. So now we had our conclusion. When a system is consisting by two bodies having the same mass, the barycenter is in the middle of this pattern. But when the system is consisting by two bodies having different masses, then the barycenter will be much closer to the higher mass elements. At the end, the barycenter of a binary star is a point much closer to the brighter star A. Hope you enjoy my video, and thank you for watching!